In the beginning, you are my dad, you are my hero, you are my everything. The heart of a child, the fun of childhood, the love that can never be torn apart, the unconditional value. You are my teacher in life, you are my most valued asset. You are my strength, you are my life. Then, you are my dad. You are my boss, you are my disciplinary, you are my fear. The fear of doing wrong, the disappointment in your eyes, the way everything I did was wrong. The way teenage years were withering our love. You are my heart, yet at a distance, you are my hero. Yet you did not know it. You are my everything, yet it wasn't apparent.
Okay, what exactly happened?
My grandpa was in town. And he came home, and all my dad's papers were laying out. I don't know what that bit means. And his keys were out. And my grandpa searched through the house and couldn't find his gun. So I called the police. And they came with dogs. And they saw that the back gate was open and they found him in the woods. He stuck the gun in his mouth and shot.
Serve God, love me, and end. This is not the end. Live unbruised, we are friends. And I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Always told us that after he passed away, he wanted his ashes spread on the Guadalupe. He liked to fish. He loved floating the river. That's actually what he wanted us to do while spreading his ashes, but it was way too cold. Even before I was born, that's where my parents went to go camping, and they went very often. He was an alcoholic and a drug addict. He'd been an alcoholic ever since I was born, maybe before that. My parents got divorced and it got worse. Him and his new wife got to the point where they were hiding bottles in their closet, in the bathroom, all over the house. And then my mom took us away from him. And he got better, at least that's what he made everyone think. But a few months ago, he got into a car wreck, and he was in the ICU for a while, and nobody understood why. And then finally somebody got to talk to the doctor, and apparently he needs alcohol to even function in general. Because he's been an alcoholic for so long, if he were to stop drinking, he could die, or he could have died. After I found that out, I was mad at him for lying to me, and I stopped talking to him. And then a few months later, I found out that he committed suicide. And I think that the reason he did that is because he had made so many mistakes that it was really hard for his children to forgive him, including me. And to be honest, we really wanted nothing to do with him. And that's gotta be hard for your own children to not want to talk to you or see you and have so much anger towards you. I can understand, kind of. But then again, there's always a chance for him to actually be sorry. And that's all it would have taken.
And what would you say to your dad?
Don't be an idiot. And I tell him I loved him. because I feel like maybe if I would have told him that, that this would have never happened. Because I haven't told him that in a long time. You're making me ruin my makeup. As the days drifted us further apart, and the ways of our lives drove us to the ends with no words, you were still my father. Then, in the end, as the gun clanged and the tear fell from my eye, you were once again my dad, my hero, my everything. I'd just been too selfish to let it be known, and now it's too late. I love you, Daddy, and always have. And in my 20th year of life, I proclaim I am shattered, beaten, and torn by the emotions of your ill suicide.